Hi, I'm Coach Shayain. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Part two with my dear friend Joe Higgins over here, who is the coach of wheelchair basketball and a very recreational avid golfer that he enjoys his game a lot. So this is part two of our series where we talk about pace of play for beginner golfers or literally anyone that's learning golf. So last week we told you, how do you keep up with the group in front of you? What does your setup over top of the ball look like? I hope you've been practicing at home. And this week we're gonna talk about hazards, which means water, bunker, what kind of golf ball do you use? What does that look like for you? And much more. So let's get started. Okay, Joe, so hazards. Hazards are essentially big bodies of water, the bunker, right? So talk me through what it looks like for yourself or for a beginner golfer, really, who maybe keeps hitting their ball in the sand trap or the bunker. What are some things you do or you suggest that they might do if they're learning the game?
So the first thing is knowing yourself. So if you're a beginner golfer, an adaptive golfer, or someone who no longer enjoys playing out of difficult situations, just skip them. So how do you skip them? So the first thing I always try to do is, we practiced last session about our routine of getting over our shot. We have another routine, which is make sure you've got your golf balls, make sure you've got your glove on, and then you hit that drive and it doesn't go where you thought it should go. It went into the rough. So my first rule of golf is, pace of play means don't look for your golf ball. If you know where it went, or somebody in your group knows where it went, assign somebody to go get it. They can spend their minute looking for it. And if they don't find it, don't worry. Have the white one in your pocket. So that's the first hazard rule, is we're out there to make sure that we enjoy the golf. So have a white ball in your pocket, put it down, and keep the pace of play. Second of all, when you're hitting and you see that big body of water, and you know that is going to eat your golf ball, this is the time to lean on Coach Cheyenne's drive. She rips it 200 yards down the middle of the fairway. Put your ball in your pocket and go past the hazard and put it down with Coach Cheyenne. This will allow you to save golf balls, save time, and it also sets a great example for your group that the reason you're out there is to enjoy and challenge yourself.
True.
Not to be in a hazard.
Right, so let's say, for example, mine doesn't go straight, but maybe my drive ends up right behind the body of water. So let's say maybe the beginner golfer is panicking and stressed because they can't carry the body of water. Maybe I can. So what do you suggest at that point? So we have extra golf balls, which everyone always, beginner or not, you should always have an extra golf ball in your pocket, in your bag, or how cute is this? This little Lululemon bag, you can put 3 golf balls in here, and it has tees, a little holder for tees, and you can literally clip it anywhere, right? So you can clip it on your fanny pack, or you can clip it right there, wherever you want, make it easy. I see you have another bag over here as well, which I see golf balls and tees in. So if you don't have this on your golf bag or on your body, the golf ball should be in your pocket. Agreed?
Yeah. And okay, these things are also great to give to your golfing buddy so that they have it. So
yeah,
when you're wondering, well, what takes longer? Don't run back to your golf cart. Don't run to your golf bag. Have it hooked to your belt and your partner will throw you a ball and away you go.
True. Very, very true. Okay, so right now we're behind the body of water. Let's say that a beginner golfer can't carry the body of water. What happens next? Am I taking extra strokes? Am I moving the ball? What are you doing at that point?
So the first thing to recognize is don't waste a shot trying to clear the water. Grab it, put it on the other side of the water, and you decide whether you want to take a penalty stroke or whether you want to just not count that stroke. The big thing is recognizing that once you get to double par, you should be picking up your ball and moving on.
Okay, so for someone that's never played golf before, what does double par mean?
So double par means on every scorecard, there is a score that the hole is supposed to take if you par it. So
a par three, yep.
A double par is double that number. So no more than six strokes.
Right. So if you're already, let's say a beginner golfer is in the fairway and they're already at five, for example, their ball is behind this body of water. You're suggesting pick it up, keep it moving to keep up with pace of play, either throw it onto the green or put it in front of the body of water to keep it going?
Yeah. So in this case, you've got one more shot left.
Right.
Why don't you go with the funnest shot and the easiest shot to hit the ball? Put your ball closest to the hole to the first person that got on the green. Yes. And they'll feel really good that you picked their location. And you putt first and away you go.
Great. So it's all about having fun when you're new out there and you're learning the game. You just want to take away all the scaries or all the big hazards and just keep moving forward and having fun. That's kind of the rhythm and the vibe I'm getting from what you're saying. Okay, so we've done the water hazard. Let's go back to my bunker question. What about the sand trap or the bunker? What are you doing in there?
Okay, everybody has to know their golfing ability and how long it takes to execute their shot. So myself, I can walk a little bit with canes. I usually use either an adaptive cart like the turf chopper, or I flag a cart so that I can drive on to the apron of the green. I don't go in the bunker. So I will either pick my ball out of the bunker, somebody will pick it out, or I really like to pick the best bunker player in my group and say, that's for you, hit it close. And that's one of my strokes. And the etiquette of golf is, if you want to play out of a hazard, like a bunker, you have to complete the etiquette by raking it. So now your pace of play falls way behind, or you're expecting somebody else to do that on your behalf. So skip that, work on your sand trap play at your local driving range, and work on your sand shots at that point.
Okay.
Not on the golf course.
So what I'm hearing is we are in the bunker. You're either asking one of your group teammates to be like, hey, go ahead and hit that out. This is your practice shot, but then you will use it. That's option A. Or option B is just asking someone to pick it out and throw it closer to the green or wherever that you feel comfortable.
Or just put it beside the bunker and away you go.
And then just go. Okay. And then obviously that saves time, raking, and just ability to go in and out. And this is really for anyone that has knee trouble, hip trouble, that's new to the game, and the sand just is so intimidating. Just tell who you're playing with, hey, I'm gonna just throw mine out. I think communication is really key in whatever you're going to do for the round of golf, correct?
Yeah, and we'll be talking about how you communicate with your foursome in another session with Coach Shayain.
Yes. That is part four. Okay, so hazards done. Talk to me about golf balls. Do you buy Pro V1s or really expensive golf balls? What's your theory, which you told me about? First of all, I love that you called the body of water the golf eater. I mean, the golf ball eater, which I thought was hilarious when you were telling me that. But a lot of balls are gonna get lost, or maybe the body of water might eat up your golf ball. So what do you specifically do if you're learning golf, or what have you done in the past in terms of golf balls? Where do you get them from?
So I always try to get my golf balls from a used golf store shop.
Okay.
Or from golf courses often have used golf balls. I always try to not fall in love with a golf ball, because if you can keep your cost down per golf ball, then your incentive to have to go look for that golf ball goes down and your enjoyability of the round goes up.
So how long do you look for yours? How, like, if you were to hit it, let's say in the trees or in a direction, you're looking for 2 minutes, a minute, 30 seconds, and then just dropping one. What does that look like for you?
So the first thing I do is I read my pace of play. Am I falling behind? Am I the last player in the group?
Yeah.
Or am I the first player in the group? Second, what's the chances of finding the golf ball?
Right.
If person says, I've got it marked, it was one bounce in, I'll send them and say, go for it.
Got it.
So I never look for a golf ball for more than 1 minute.
Great.
And usually I have the fastest person in my group look for the golf ball.
Great. So if you're new to golf and you've taken your minute or two to look for it, Joe recommends grab another golf ball, throw it down, and keep moving forward. Don't become all upset and annoyed that you've lost a golf ball, because you have a few in your pockets and we're just moving forward. Okay, keeping up with that, the last question for pace of play is, talk to me about, do you play every single hole? What happens if you're falling behind? What does that look like for you specifically? And what should it look for beginners? So tell me about you first.
So what I try to do is try to recognize, how much energy am I putting into this round of golf? And am I getting tired? And what is my pace of play? So if I'm playing a par five that I know I can't reach,
yep,
I will skip either the first two shots or the first three shots of that hole, or I may skip the whole hole together and just take a break and cheerlead my group. Right. And then I move on. And I look at the scorecard to look at which holes would be the funnest to play.
Oh, fun.
And that's how I do choose when to skip and when to keep playing.
So you usually play, let's say, the first hole and the ninth holes to start off and to come back in. So you do with the group, and then in between 2 and 8, you might choose to skip 3 in a row or skip 2, and then just kind of feel how your body's responding to
how my body is responding, how my group is doing, what's my level of enjoyment and frustration. So
Great.
The mental part of golf is just as important as the physical part of golf. Why are we there? To have fun.
To have fun. So any beginner golfer out there, do not be embarrassed to skip a hole, to skip a shot, to just enjoy. Start it off, come back in on the ninth, and then in between, do as you wish, whatever your body feels comfortable with, whatever you feel comfortable with. Just let your group know that you're going to join them on that hole, or you're just going to cheerlead them on that specific hole. Sounds fair?
Great.
Great. If you have any questions at all about hazards, pace of play, all things we just spoke about on this video, leave them in the comments below. As I mentioned in my first video, this is a safe space. We're here to help and to educate everyone on what a beginner golfer looks like, what it means to be out there for the first time. Keeping sure you're keeping in pace with the group in front of you is really important. Between 10 to 15 minutes per hole maximum. We'll see you for part 3 next week, but make sure you leave them in the comments below. And if you haven't liked or subscribed, make sure you do that. See you next week.